Monitoring your website can seem like a full-time job, and that is why many SEO specialists, webmasters, and business owners use automated tools and report generators. SEOsitecheckup.com offers several helpful SEO tools, including a general analysis report. The report is super simple to run. Just enter in the website URL into the box, select the factors to be checked, and hit go. Now, once the report has been generated, it is chock full of information. And for many business owners, this information can be a little tough to understand at first. Luckily, the report offers helpful tips throughout that give summaries of what each section means and helpful tips on how to fix any issues. But let's go over them. Here's a summary of the report with all of the factors, including a quick overview of each item. At the top of the page, there's a scoring system displayed. This scoring system gives a quick glance at the overall performance of the site. The SEO score is displayed first, letting you know generally how well your site is optimized. The next items include how many factors were tested that passed, how many have warnings associated with them, and how many have failed. If any tests were performed with unresolved results, they will be displayed in the list box. The first portion of the report includes the most common SEO issues, such as meta tags, H1 and H2 tags, keyword usage, sitemap, code-to-text ratio, and Google Analytics. This is where most problems are most commonly found, so pay attention to the report closely and be sure to note any instructions given on how to rectify issues. If your website title or description is too short or too long, it will be displayed here. Most search engines will truncate or cut off titles up to 70 characters and descriptions up to 160 characters in length. This section shows you the most common keywords found on your website and the number of times they are used. This keywords usage section lets you know if you have forgotten to include any particular keywords in your meta tags. The search engines use meta tags to properly identify the topic of your page. Using H1 and H2 tags throughout your site not only helps it look nicer for visitors, but it also helps optimize it for SEO. So this section displays not only if the headings are used, but where they can be found on your page. Search engines use programs called spiders to search your site and bring back information for indexing purposes. If there are parts of your page that you do not want to have indexed, a Robots.txt file placed in the root folder of your website manages that for better optimization. Every website needs a sitemap.xml file in order to rank well within the search engines. The XML file allows the search engine to crawl through the site's pages and locate important data for each page. The search engines use this file to check how often a site is updated and how important it is compared to other URLs on the site. This section displays whether or not the site is properly using a favicon. Favicons are those small icons that appear in the browser's URL navigation bar. They're used not only for generally branding a site, but they make it easy for users to locate you in a large pool of bookmarked sites. And you look really, really unprofessional if you don't have one. The total number of page objects is listed here, such as HTML pages, CSS files, images, scripts, and videos. The number of page objects can cause the page to load slowly, so if you're having issues, be sure to refer to tips in this section for increasing your overall load speed. This tool checks the website URL to ensure that all links from inside are SEO friendly. Website monitoring is very important, so your site should definitely be using a Google Analytics tracking code. This section analyzes the image tags on your site and ensures that they have the required alt attribute. If your page is using inline CSS properties, it can increase the text-to-code ratio if they are not moved to an external folder. This section displays how your website looks on the search engine results pages, and it'll give you a quick glance to determine if your website title or description is too long, for instance. This offers a quick view of the keywords used on your site and how frequently they appear. The words are in alphabetical order, and the keywords that appear more often are in larger fonts. This section displays if the site is using old, outdated HTML tags that have lost browser support. How fast your page loads is obviously important to the search engines, but even more so to the users who visit your site. So if your page is too slow loading when visitors come, they are more likely to back out, and this itself creates a high bounce rate that can reflect poorly on your search engine rankings. This shows you how large the HTML code is on your page, not including images or external CSS files and JavaScript. The lower the number, the faster the page loads. HTML compression helps to decrease page size and increase load speed, and in addition to all the tests above, the overall speed and performance of your website is tested in the following areas: page cache, any flash elements, nested tables, image expiration tags, doc type, frame set, site loading speed, as well as JavaScript and CSS minification. and there are several items tested for the server and security of the website. It checks the stability of the server, the security of the server, and even tests for malware. This includes URL canonicalization, directory browsing, libpurl access, server signature, plain text emails, IP canonicalization, and safe browsing. Mobile-friendly websites are no longer just a recommendation for good SEO, they're actually a requirement. So this section offers a media query responsive test to check the functionality of your site on mobile devices and gives you a snapshot of what your mobile site looks like to the customer. So if you have not set up your website to function in mobile environments, you'll probably find some issues that will be displayed in this section. Not surprisingly, social media has become a powerful marketing tool, and it is a huge part of your business's overall success. It is vitally important to implement a social media campaign into your SEO efforts if you want positive results. So this section shows you if your website is connected to any social media platform, and if not, how to resolve the issue. It checks all social media platforms like Facebook, Twitter, Google+, LinkedIn, and Pinterest. Social network plugins need to be placed on your pages, such as a Facebook like button or a Twitter share button, in order to pass this test. In this section, you will also be given a quick glance at your social media activity. You can check how many Facebook likes you have, how many shares, and how many comments. Twitter offers the number of tweets that have been posted, and Google+ displays how many total plus ones you have. Feel free to check out our other videos so that you can keep fine-tuning and getting the most out of your SEO. And click subscribe to stay updated with new tips and tricks to get you to the top of the search engine results pages.